And because number four was so short, the story, I will tell number five. Number five, actually, I'm jumping out of sequence. It was when I was 16. I didn't think about it at first. Well, I thought about it, but I don't know why I didn't tell it right away. Anyways, as most 16-year-olds, as soon as you get your license, you're like crazy, you know? Which I disagree with 16 being the driving age. I think it should be at least 18, if not 21. I think 21's a little too old. I think 16's too young. Maybe 18 would be just about right. Your mind's not developed and matured enough when you're 16, and my story is proof of that. I was in a backcountry road where there's lots of hills and there's no paved roads, and it's nice roads, but they're just not paved. And so so you can maintain speed on it and be okay. Well, what had happened is I was going way too fast. I had a Toyota 4Runner, which are extremely top heavy. And not really a good first car for a 16-year-old. So I was going down this road at about around 70 or so. Wasn't smart, wasn't thinking, and fogging up. And I come over this hill crest, and right on the right-hand side of the road was a deer. So I thought I was gonna hit it, and my natural instinct and reaction was like to swerve out of the way from it. And because I almost, you know, because I thought I was gonna hit it and my swerve, it threw me into a fishtail. And so I'm fishtailing down this slope of this hill, and off to the left is a cliff. It wasn't like I was on the top of a mountain, but it was a decent drop into just like a rock wall. I'd say maybe about a 20-foot drop, maybe a little more, I don't know. I wasn't very good at gauging distances there, but so I'm fishtailing, and there's a cliff down on to my left, maybe about 30 yards or so, maybe more, and telephone poles and stuff to the right. So first I'm like going straight towards the cliff, so I'm like, shit, so I swing the wheel the other way, and then I'm going right towards the telephone pole, and then I correct from the telephone pole, and I'm headed towards the cliff again, and I'm just like, fuck. So I yank it as hard as I can, because I don't want to go over this cliff, because that would have been death right there, easily. Going 70 miles an hour off the cliff, and then free falling, and then run, and then hitting face first into a rock wall, like, yeah, I don't think so. So I crank the wheel as hard as I can, and I start rolling. So between the fishtailing and the braking, I probably slowed down to about 60. So the 4Runner is just rolling. I think we rolled about, I don't know, maybe four or five times. And I missed going off that cliff by my back tire was hanging. I landed upright. My back tire like was almost hanging off that cliff. And the car was, one of the spots that I had landed in the roll was right on the upper, like see on this Jeep, the upper left corner, right above his mirror, right where you're, you know, like right here on your car. That was like one of the landing spots. But I was being thrown around so violently inside that my head was like down to the right when we landed on the top left of the car, okay? So that whole top left, like, let's see if I, okay, so let's say it's like here. When I lifted my head back up, it was like down here. So like my head was like kind of like cramped against it, if that makes sense. And every window was blown out, like the whole tires and stuff weren't even like attached to the car anymore. And I mean, it was like bad. It was a nasty looking accident. If you were to drive by and there was the lady that did finally come and rescue me, she didn't even, no one drove by that road for about an hour. Anyways, I emerged from that car accident without a scratch. Not a single cut, not a single bruise, not a single scratch, nothing. And the police officer and everything showed up. They were like, where's all the dead people that are in the car with you? And I'm like, there's no one in the car. It's just me. He's like, do you have any idea how lucky you are? He's like, not only did you not fly over that cliff right there, but you don't even have a freaking scratch on you. He's like, there's some angel looking over you. And it's at life number, what was that, five? Five. I'm starting to, I'm like, I agree with you, sir. So, just a punk kid, and there's life number five.